Some people, when using Batch, have a nice predefined tag that tells them when their operation is starting and when it's finishing. However, most people don't have that luxury. They have a combination of different tags or conditions that determine when a batch is supposed to start. And for those people, and that's very common, we have to use some other mechanism to create our active point or trigger tag. In this case, we're going to suggest you use PI PEs or performance equation tags. Performance equation tags are server-based calculations that have access to all the data on your system. They can see snapshot data, archive data. They have some predefined functions in the steam table calculations. You can make performance equation expressions as simple or complex as you need to be. And you can base them either on events taking place or what we call scan-based. Scan-based would be based on a clock value. So every 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 30 seconds, whatever rate whatever rate you set in there is when we'll evaluate the performance equation. And if the performance equation conditions are true, then we can start our batch. The performance equation mechanism, it's formerly called the PI performance equation scheduler, is run just like every other interface in the system. There's a batch file. This interface batch file only differs from their other interfaces in that this one is in the PI and bin or binaries folder. And it is edited just with any text editor or ICU, interface configuration utility. And at the most, because it's already set up and running, you may have to add scan classes, but that's about the only thing you'd ever have to do to the performance equation engine. Here's an example of an 8-hour scan where we've got hours, minutes, seconds, and there's an offset of 7 hours, 7 hours, 0 minutes, 0 seconds. That means that this calculation will occur every 8 hours starting at 7 a.m. each day. So 7 a.m. and 3 p.m., and then we can go all the way out to 9 p.m. That is when the scans will occur. So if the interface starts up at 9:30, the first scan will occur at 3 p.m. If we go to the file, the PI/binary or bin folder, we'll find the PI performance equation scheduler.bat file. We can edit that, and you can edit that with any text editor, and you can see the scan frequencies are all listed in order here. You want to be sure to add your scan frequency to the end of this list, because any tags that have been created using the existing scan classes need to maintain this specific order in the list of scan frequencies. If I were to add a new frequency at the beginning of the list, every tag I had previously defined using scan class number 1 would now be using my new scan class. So you always want to add them to the end of the file. Remember, after you edit the batch file, you will have to restart the PI performance equation scheduler interface for those changes to be picked up. When you build tags for performance equations, it's very simple. You can either use Point Builder, or if you're using SMT, we have a very nice performance equation scheduler tool that we'll see in a few moments. All of the settings are very easily clickable within your performance equation scheduler. We'll see how to build those in a few moments. The PI performance equation syntax is fairly easy to remember. The only thing you have to remember is that tags and timestamps are all in single quotes, and strings are in double quotes. So if you wanted to compare a tag name to a certain condition or greater than a certain value, you would simply use the expression tag name in single quotes, greater than, the greater than symbol, and then the value. So it's very simple to put together a PI performance equation syntax. The performance equations support all the standard operators, plus, minus, divide, to the power of. It supports all the standard logical operators like and, or, and not, and all the standard relational operators like greater than, less than, equal to, so on and so forth. We have a full range of statistical functions like average, mean, min, max, range, standard deviation. All these are available through the PI performance equations. We have examples of time values. So if you wanted to start a a batch when a point, the total time of a point was greater than a certain value, you might use the time GT or time greater than, or time greater than or equal to, and track and perform your calculation and base it on a tag being over or greater than or greater or equal to a certain value for a given amount of time. So you would compare it not just to the value being over that a certain threshold, but a value being over the threshold for a certain number of seconds. We've got some more find the timestamp when a point was not equal to or equal to, greater than, less than. These results actually come back as timestamps, and or you can use any of the standard mathematical functions like square, tangent, sine. Any of these will work with the performance equation functionality. You can even build if-then-else expressions. So you could say if expression number one was true, then you might have a value of zero. And if else, then you might have a value of one. That would be a very convenient way of creating a trigger for your tags. One little note, some logical construction calculation engines will allow you to use an if-then statement without the else. The performance equations engine does require the else statement. So if you have a function where there's no else statement, it's just if and then, you can use the else no output function to say just do nothing in an alternate condition. So if you're going to use if then else, you have to use the if then and the else, and if you have no else condition, use no output.